Hello! Today we're going to be introducing you to Confluence and all that this wiki can do for you. First, to get to Confluence, you should go to classwiki.uww.edu. This is the address for the site homepage. Then click on the Login button in the upper right-hand corner. Doing this takes you to the UWW login, where you type in your net ID and password. This then takes you to your personal homepage on Confluence. To get started in Confluence, we recommend going through the checklist. This takes you through some of the processes that you will be using most regularly. This is what we will be addressing in this video. To get started, create your homepage. Click Edit in the upper right-hand corner of the page, just under the search bar here. This is where you should start building it up by adding pictures and text. Don't be afraid to change up the front or the page layout. This is your chance to be creative. You can upload images or type whatever you want as your homepage for your class. You can even upload attachments to the pages. Just go to the bottom of the page and click on the Attachments button. Another window will pop up, and there you can choose a file to attach to the page for your students to view. This could be used for your syllabus or any other important documents that you would like to be made available to you. When you have made the changes you want, click Save. The next step after beautifying your homepage is to start creating your work pages. To do this, you can click on the Create button on the blue bar running across the top of the screen. A window then pops up with several different options for what kind of page you want. This helps you to begin. I recommend carefully going through all of these options and start thinking out what kind of page you would like to build. Do you want to share files with your class? Choose the File List page. Do you want them to practice making important decisions? Make a Decision page. Do you want them to reflect on their choices? Try the retrospective page. There are pages for all of these things, and having these educational tools can really enhance the student's learning experience. A nifty feature that is available in Confluence is your ability to comment and like things in it. We can all agree that this is unique for an education site, but the familiarity of social media could encourage more student interaction. After starting to build your new virtual classroom environment, you are then presented with the opportunity to make the site work for you by branding your space and adjusting your page's permissions. To do this, click the Space Tools icon in the left-hand sidebar of the page. You'll see a variety of options. If you want to change the layout of your sidebar, click on the Configure sidebar. You can change between two different organizational systems on the sidebar, child pages or page tree. Choose whatever makes things easier for you. If you want to change who has control over what on your pages, click Permissions. And then set specific permissions for each person on the list. The last thing I would like to point out is the Tools menu. It is located in the upper right-hand corner of the homepage. This drop-down menu contains important options like page history and restrictions. Another nifty thing that this wiki has is the option to export pages as PDFs and also as Word documents. You can move and copy and delete pages as well if you want to. If you take the time to explore all of these options and their usefulness, then I have no doubt that in no time you'll be using Confluence with confidence. That's all for now. Make sure to look for our future videos with a more in-depth look at Confluence and all that it offers. Thank you for watching!